This sounds silly, but I recently began to wonder whether or not I'm possessed. Everything I discuss here could easily have a logical, non-ghostly explanation. I'll just explain some particular instances of what may have been visitations. Then I'll get to the reason for the title of this post. Apologies in advance, this will be long and boring. As long as I can remember, I suffer from night terrors and sleep paralysis. I don't remember any of the terrors, but I remember each episode of sleep paralysis. The old lady. It all began with the old lady. I'd hear her down the hall, dragging one foot after the other. Each step brought her closer to my room. I could never move or even close my eyes. The door would creak open, and I'd see her silhouette. She was hunched over. She wore some sort of loose-fitting robes. A hood shrouded her face. I'm actually scaring myself now. The old lady creeps towards my bed. I would try to scream, but the best I could was manage a pitiful moan. Then she would lean over my bed, and the moment before I could see her face, she'd be gone, and I could move and scream again. This happened countless times, and only once when I was maybe 12 or 13 did I actually see her face. It was a familiar face and not particularly frightening. It was similar to my aunt's on my mom's side of the family, the Lebanese-Armenian side. If I recall correctly, that was the last time I experienced that particular episode until I was much older. I was in the Air Force, just like when I was a kid. She came down the hall and into my dorm room. This time she couldn't seem to find my bed, which was in the corner. You had to turn to see it. She walked past my bed and then she was gone. That was the last time I ever saw her. My mom's best friend died of a self-inflicted gunshot wound. My mom's best friend killed himself when I was maybe 15 or 16. No one is really sure why, but it might have something to do with his boyfriend at the time. The guy was really cool and thought of him as part of the family. Anyways, so around the same time, I was going through some typical teenage angst and depression, including suicidal thoughts. I can't say how serious I was about suicide, but I think about it often and felt more at ease when I did. I slept on the living room couch often at that age. Parents didn't get along and slept at separate ends of the house. So I kind of had that whole area to myself. Anyways, one night, I was lying on the couch pondering suicide. Then he was standing there. My mom's friend, just a foot or two away from the couch. I wasn't paralyzed, but I couldn't turn away. His face was swollen. It was almost pale blue. There was a hole in his shirt, crusted with blood, where his heart would be. That's where he shot himself. He looked down at me and said, "Don't do it. You don't go where you think you go." And then he was gone. I told my mom about it the next day. She wasn't the one who found his body, but she saw him before he was hauled away. She said his face was swollen. But a lot of dead people have swollen faces. It's not so strange. And I described what he was wearing. It was exactly what he had on the day he died. I never seriously considered suicide after that. My childhood friend killed himself too. Rich was my best, closest friend. He also had a lot of emotional issues and a fucked up family. A year or two before I left for the Air Force, his parents divorced and he moved out to a neighboring city. It was a whole fucked up situation and I just kind of stopped hanging out with him. A few years later, I'm home on leave. I start thinking about Rich and how bad I feel for abandoning him. As I search around for his number, the phone rings. It's the parents of another friend. Rich had been found parked alongside an old country road, dead. I was laying in bed a year or so later, feeling really guilty about Rich. Always felt like I abandoned him when he needed me most. Over and over again, I just repeat how I wished he was there so I could apologize, tell him what a terrible friend I'd been, and ask for his forgiveness. I rolled over facing the wall, and that's when I felt him there standing over the bed. I don't know how, but I knew it was him. In my mind, I saw his swollen, discolored face. It looked nothing like the showing at the funeral. There, his face was caked with makeup, hard to touch. Yes, I touched him. I was terrified, too afraid to turn around and face him. So I just cowered in bed with my back to Rich until I no longer felt his presence. Recently, my episode sleep paralysis tapered off quite a bit as I got older. I have them now maybe once or twice a year. Sometimes they're not even frightening at the start. My last two were really close to lucid dreams, except my physical body couldn't move during one of them. It was like I was watching a film projected on the walls of my room. In the film, I was hanging out with a couple, helping cook a turkey. It was interesting and quite a trip. Then things in the film started to get weird. Then they got downright frightening. Then I heard the voices, and over them I heard the voice. The voice. In every one of the last 10 or so episodes of sleep paralysis, there has been one constant: the voice. Sometimes the episode starts with shadows that become twisted creatures that swirl around me. Then come the voices, dozens of them whispering, laughing, deep voices, high-pitched voices. I don't know if they whisper in another language, in gibberish, or if I just can't understand them because they all talk and laugh at once. Then I hear the voice. The voice is loud. And unlike the others who swirl around with the shadows, I hear the voice as if it's right next to my left ear. Before I hear him, I'm fucking terrified. But after I hear him in my ear, I feel a kind of Lovecraftian terror I couldn't possibly describe. Up until Saturday night, I can't recall whether or not the voice has actually spoken to me. It laughs. I know that. That brings us to Saturday night. I'd fallen asleep on the couch and began a slightly off yet fairly routine dream, which I can hardly recall. I was somewhere doing something when things started to get weird. And for some reason, I asked myself, am I possessed? I heard the same voices swirling around, laughing, whispering. Then I was back on the couch, paralyzed. The voice laughed in my ear and said,